here's how to make this bursting firework effect in PowerPoint. As always, there are three easy steps. Make the firework, make the tail, and animate the firework. Let's jump to number one and learn how to make the explosion part. Let's give it a white background so you can see all the colors, including the black. The firework is made up of three different pieces. I wasn't sure what to call them, but for simplicity, let's just call them the circle, the large flare, and the small flare. I'll show you how to make each of these, and then we'll combine them all together. Let's take a look at the circle first. This is basically just a circle shape with a gradient effect. Let me show you how I colored it in. So we have a radial gradient here that starts from the center. In terms of the colors, the first one is the innermost color and it's yellow. Next, we have orange at the 19% position. Now you don't have to have it exactly at 19%. That was just the position I landed on when I was doing this. You can have it higher or lower, whatever you like. What's more interesting here though are the two colors on the right side, which are both black. The rightmost color actually has 100% transparency, and then the other one is at 90% transparency and is in the position of 78%. And again, you don't have to have it exactly at 78, but that's just what worked for me. Next, let's go to the large flare, which is actually a 24-point star, as you can see when I move the adjuster there. You can get the star by going to Insert, Shape, and choosing that from the menu. You can then adjust it like this. And if you don't have this shape in your version of PowerPoint, you can always just create 12 intersecting lines to get a similar effect. Now let's see how I colored this in. Basically, the orange part you see is just the shape outline. There is no fill, and you're working with just the line, which is 0.5 in weight and just the default settings for everything else. See, if I change it to red, it changes everything to red, which confirms that there's no fill. Now let's go to our last piece, which is the 32-point star. It's the same thing here. You can get it from the shapes menu and adjust it to look like ours. It has the same settings as the other flare, except it's a darker color. If you like, what you can do is adjust the width of the line to add some style. You can't really see the difference now, but you might if I zoom in here. So you can adjust that, the width of the line up or down as you like. So just play around with that and see what width you like for the two stars or flares. Great, now it's time to put them all together and make sure that the circle is on top. And let's make the background black again, and we're ready for the next step, which is making the tail. Let's just delete the top to focus on the tail. And it's really easy. It's just a rectangle with a gradient fill. I'll show you what it looks like. Here we have a linear gradient with a 270-degree angle. For the colors, the black is 100% transparent, the orange in the middle is 30% transparent, and the yellow-orange at the top is not transparent at all. The other interesting piece you can add here is an outline with a cool dash effect. Again, play around with these. You'll use different ones, different dashes, different outline styles, depending on the width of your tail. For the fireworks in my video, for example, I originally had the tails at 0.03, but when I originally compressed the video, somehow one of the tails wasn't showing up. So I had to remake all of them to be 0.05 in width instead, and then they all worked. So 0.05 is the width of the tails in my video. So that's all for this step. Let's get to the fun part now of animating it all. The animations aren't too complicated either. The firework part has three animations and the tail has two. But before we do anything else, let's just group the firework pieces together and then put that group together with the tail. Let's now animate the firework. We'll go up to Animate and put a Zoom Entrance, a Grow Shrink for emphasis, and finally, add a dissolve out for our exit effect. For the tail, we add a wipe entrance and random bars for the exit effect. Now we make everything 0.25 in duration, as well as start after previous for the timing. Now take the entrance for rectangle 6, which is our tail, and move it all the way to the top, and then take the exit of the tail, rectangle 6, and move it right after the entrance of the firework. Then change it to start with previous. So this is what the final pattern should look like for it to work properly. And here is the final result. And let's zoom in to see it again. And there you have it, another new trick to add to your toolkit. I encourage you to really try out different ways to both design and animate this, since fireworks can honestly be done in so many different ways. Well, thanks again for watching, and check out my other videos if you haven't already, and I'll see you for my next one.